Yo, so what's good, fam? It's your man Jay, and I'm back with another episode of Evolutionary Comics. This is a very special episode because as I want people to believe in my blog and to tune in and to check me out, I also want them to believe in the products that I show you, the comic books that I show you. So this episode is brought to you by Touched by Ash, one of the premier hairdressers, I guess that's the same word. She does braids, she does hair, she does a little bit of everything, but she's located in St. Petersburg, Florida. I'm gonna put her information below. You're gonna see her logo pop up. If you need your hair braided, you need your hair done, holla at my girl. That's fam, by the way. So hit up Touched by Ash. All right, so getting into it, this is, I've been excited. I've had this box for about a week, but today happens to be the opening of, I guess, the next Kickstarter. I'm not sure which one it is, but this project is basically funded by Kickstarters, and it's something that should be on a major scale. I'm gonna tell you, by far, this is my favorite comic book that I have read in I don't know how long. The artwork is dope as is dope. So you can see the cover art. The cover art is done by Giancarlo Burnell, and the author is Newton Lillevoix, something like that. Newton, my bad for mispronouncing your name. I've been trying to catch a video where you're actually saying your last name, which has been difficult, because you always say it's your man Newton. So that's my man. We've exchanged emails back and forth since I ordered this. You notice that this was actually my second order, because I ordered my first set, issues 1, 2, and 3. It's right now, it's only 3 issues out. So the next one is the 4th issue, which I guess that's what the Kickstarter is about. But I had to order another box, and my purpose in ordering it was, a couple of weeks ago, it was my birthday, and my wife decided to, you know, kind of as a joke, to put a little message on Facebook, you know, about people being, you know, and how crazy I am about comic books. And she said, you know, send your boy $3.99 for a comic book. And people did. And I was shocked. I was overwhelmed, because I didn't think that, you know, that many people pay attention to me. I'm kind of a low-key guy. I'm an introvert. A lot of blurbs are, but, you know, it is what it is. So people start, you know, shooting me money, and Ashley, she by far, she hooked your boy up. So with that being said, with the money, all the money that people sent me, because I have like a little bit of a budget that I allocate just for comic books each week that kind of keeps it going just for me, as you know, as it goes. But she invested in this vlog for me, and I appreciate her a million for it. And you know, that was what was able to fund this particular episode. So this is a couple of, I have like maybe 3 or 4 copies of the Crescent City Monsters. And what I'm gonna do is, when I reach 1,000 subscribers, I'm gonna gift that 1,000. I'm gonna do like, I was gonna say whoever is the exact 1,000, but I'm not gonna do it that way. I'm gonna figure out some kind of system to where I do a giveaway. And the contents of this box, with the exception of the shirt that's in here, I'm gonna give that away. So people, subscribe, you know, hit me up, you know, let me know how you feel, hit up the comments, you know, give me comments about my vlog, because, you know, like I say, when you believe in something, then you kind of invest in it. And I want to bring awareness, and that's one of the biggest purposes of this vlog, is that I bring awareness to the black creators, the black artists, and the black writers, and definitely the black characters, so everybody will know that there's something out there for them, no matter what color, race, creed you are. You know, there's something out there. The black comic book industry is very small in comparison to the comic book industry as a whole. With the invent of Black Panther, the movie, coming out, people are starting to wake up and starting to realize that, hey, it's some dope stuff out there. But I want you to know that there's more than just Black Panther. He happens to be the greatest Marvel superhero ever in my eyes. But there's other imprints that are putting out some good stuff. And on the cover, this is my man Jonas. And Jonas happens to be a blues musician in my second home in New Orleans. And New Orleans is me and my wife's favorite city. That's every year we take a vacation to New Orleans for some reason or another. But I absolutely love it. I love the atmosphere. I love the food. I love the culture. And Yeah, so anyway, that's where this is based at, and it's part of that voodoo culture lore, but it's a mix, but it's dope. So without, continuing to ramble, because I'm a talker, I'm an introverted talker, so without further yapping by the captain, I'm going to pop this box open. I'm going to show you guys what's in it. Like I said, this is from Dream Fury Comics. My man Newton sent me this, courtesy of Touched by Ash. And, these are the comics. This is the shirt. Oh, yeah. It's a big guy shirt. So, I got to keep this one for myself. And let's see. I'm going to show y'all first before I check it out. But all right, so that's the shirt with Dream Fury Comics on the back. And on the cover, that's my man Jonas, the sorcerer. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about the story. The heads he have, they're creatures called Munches. So actually, I'm gonna put the shirt on. So yeah, so this is my Dream City, Crescent City Monster shirt. I'm loving it. And these are my issues. This is a copy of the one. And I'm gonna tell you, the thing about Newton is, Newton is a dope guy. Like I said, we've exchanged emails briefly, and he showed his appreciation for me ordering again. And every order that you get, the only way you can get these really is by ordering it from him. I'll put the details below, but he sends you a little personalized thank you note. And he also sends some cards. This is with Jonas. And this right here is Queenie. She is the queen of the Grunches. And they have a major role in the first issue in what happens with Jonas. So I'm not going to tell too much of the story because I want you guys to go out and read it yourself. I didn't even notice She-Hulk was there. I like She-Hulk. That grin. It's a Captain Kirk thing, man. Alright, so this is a second version. This is the regular edition. I think I have the number 2 variant cover. But slide that in right there. And when Jonas does his thing, he ends up having to fight some zombie type characters. This is the actual second, this is the cover of the variant edition. So I think I may have this one, and I'm gonna definitely keep one of these for myself. But issues 1, 2, and 3 will be going out like in a giveaway in the future. And this is the third issue. It's also a variant cover, and the chick on the cover, her name is Callie, and the guy in the background, that's Baron Samdi, I guess how you say his name. But she's actually possessed by him, and it's crazy because within the comic book, she meets up with this other chick, and things happen that are more for him than for her. But that's a little part of the comic book. But yeah, so it's dope. Get rid of that envelope. The paper that is the cover is like that thick paper. It's I can't even think of what type of paper it's called. I'm not a paper expert. I don't know. I ain't gonna try to tell you. I just know that it's thick. It's durable. It's built to last. So when you purchase one of these comic books, it's gonna last. It's very, very well made. And like I say, I'm gonna let you see for yourself. Look at the artwork. I'm telling you, the artwork is dope. That's what caught my attention first, and I've been running with it since. And the characters are beautiful. Like I say, they it's something for everybody. This character right there, she's gonna be like a love interest for my man Jonas, like in the future. But she kind of reminds me of this chick I know, this model, this young lady, I'm sorry. But yeah, it's dope. And just as a brief, as I show you some more panels, I'm gonna tell you the story. This is how the bio reads. The story introduces us to a sorcerer named Jonas and explores what happens when his life is violently taken away from him by the monsters of New Orleans. Jonas is a young blues musician deep-seated in that New Orleans supernatural world. Someone from the supernatural world puts a bounty on his head that not only changes Jonas's life, but also the course of the entire supernatural world. Jonas is pulled back from the dead and desperately needs to find out who put the bounty on him. Crescent City Monsters was created in 2017 and started out as a webcomic series. After building up a fan base, Dream Fury Comics launched a crowdfunding campaign in 2018 to fund the printing of issue 1. Following the first successful campaign, two more successful Kickstarters were funded for printing of issues 2 and 3. The creative team consists of Haitian-American writer Newton Lillevoy and Filipino artist Giancarlo Burnell. So, like I said, this is by far one of my favorite comic books ever. It's definitely the dopest one that has come out in a while. And like I said, once I reach 1,000 subscribers, I'm gonna do something. You know, it's gonna be, you're gonna have to do something like, you're gonna have to like and follow and you know, some other stuff on this channel, but it's also, you're gonna have to do some other stuff as well. In fact, before we go, so this is from, these are from the first order that I placed for my personal, when I was just getting the comic book for myself, when I saw it, I knew that I wanted it, but just to kind of pique your interest in it a little bit more, other characters within it, this is Kingsley, and Kingsley is shady. He was a part of the Grunge crew or whatever, but he did something and he kind of backstabbed Queenie, and even though she's a bad guy already, but this guy's the worst guy. So you're gonna see their relationship. This is Box and Brittany, and these are some young kids that they're part of the supernatural world. It's Brittany Robitaille and her younger brother Jacques Box Robitaille, and they were born into a family of sorcerers and inherited magical abilities from their deceased parents. This is a picture of Grunches at dinner. They wilding out. I know some people liked it. This is a Munin. I guess that's how you Munin. But this guy is, he's like a crow, part human. He's a supernatural creature as well. But he is kind of like the bodyguard for Jonas. He's like Jonas's, you know, right-hand man, you know, what nobody knows about it because he's a bird and he's flying around, but he's always talking to Jonas. But whenever Jonas gets in trouble, you know, he manifests into a human form. So, yeah, these are two or other prints of things that I have before. But again, this is Crescent City Monsters. This is my pick of the year. So I just came upon it. It came out in 2017 as a web-based comic, but it's been out for a while. I've been wanting it. I've seen it a couple of times in different places, but I decided that, you know, hey, in no time like the present, and I started buying copies, and I got issues 1, 2, and 3. I'm telling you, you read 1, you're going to want 2. You read 2, you're going to have to have everything else that's put out by Crescent City Monsters and Dream Fury Comics. So it's dope. The artwork is amazing, top-notch, bar none. This can go toe-to-toe with any comic book created, in my opinion. Jonas has the chance to be, not like on maybe on Black Panther level, because that took from 1966 to today, you know, he's just really popping with, you know, people on the outside, so to speak. For us blurs, we've been on the Black Panther since we were little kids, so to speak, but Jonas has potential to be there. So this is a great story. The storyline is dope. The artwork is dope. I can't say enough about it. So check it out. I'm going to put the details below. I'm going to put some information about the Kickstarter so you guys can contribute to that and jump in on that, because I think Newton is gonna do like a little giveaway. One of the amazing things, I'm telling you, Newton is dope. I love this guy. I've never met him, but I love his creation. I believe in his work. But Newton is doing this as part of this particular Kickstarter. He asked a question, and I'm not sure if he definitively said that he's definitely gonna do it, but how dope is it if he does do it? He's going to, people that contribute and join the Kickstarter, he's gonna choose one of those people to actually become a character in one of the upcoming issues. Now, I don't know about you, I'm that fanatical about comic books, but I think it would be dope as hell to be in a comic book, to have your image in a comic book. Like, one day I'm gonna write my own. My brother-in-law, he's an artist, so I may get him to draw it and whatever. But to be in a comic book at this day and age, hey, that's fire. You know, so anyway, I'm going to wrap this up and stop rambling because I do that sometimes. Y'all got to tell me. Hit me up in the comments. Damn, dog, you talk too much. It's whatever. But shout out to Blurred Core, my Facebook group. If you're a blurred and you're looking for a home for, you know, just to communicate, no matter where you are, it's Facebook. You can join in and talk to my guy Darren, who I call him the OG. Him and Antonio Brown are like, I don't know, they're just the OGs. I know I'm older than both of them, but they're the OGs when it comes to comic books, because if there's a comic book that you want and that you've heard about and, you know, that's out there that has some value to it, these guys got it. And they know Darren, he has a vast knowledge. Antonio has a vast knowledge. My man Kenya, he's young in the game, I guess, but he's up and coming with his comic book collection. Anyway, we talk about a lot of good topics within black comics and black characters. There's a lot of questions that are asked that we bounce around on each other, and it's a great place for information. So if you're a new collector and you want somewhere where you can find out information that you may not know about, join us on Blurred Core. That, like I said, that's the Facebook group, and you know, I'll see you there if you decide to subscribe. Again, I want to give special thanks out to Ashley, Touched by Ash in St. Petersburg, Florida. She does the braids, she does the hair. She's done my daughter's hair. She's excellent, very friendly, a beautiful person, and she's very talented when it comes to doing the braids and whatever. So yeah, check her out. Oh, and before I go, I always have to give shout out to my wife, because it's very essential that, like, if you're this fanatical about something and you invest this much into something, especially when you're investing your own money in something that's like a hobby, it doesn't definitively give you like a return as far as, you know, making a financial income. We'll talk. I have another episode that's going to come up about comics and the economics of comics. So that's going to be something that's going to be one of my future episodes. And I'm going to help people to the financial aspect of comic books, the value, how things increase. You might have a cover comic book you bought that's $3.99, and a month later you see it on eBay and it's $250 and you don't know why. You know, I'm getting into those type of things. But I will say thank you, baby, because my wife, she's been ordering stuff online for her birthday that's coming up. And like I said, you always gotta have a partner that's, you know, I'm not gonna say they have to be so invested into your hobby, but they have to be accepting to a certain level. And she is. She's dope as hell when it comes to it. A lot of the figures and stuff behind me, she purchased them. I have like a $400 figure of Black Panther that we had to order. This, I think it's like a one of 500 or something like that, but there's not many of them. But she ordered it like the first year that we were together, and then from then on I knew, you know, hey, this might be the one. So yeah, so she wifed up. So, but this is something she ordered, which I don't know what it is. She probably gonna be mad because I opened it before she got home, but she know I'm a big ass kid, so I'm gonna see what she ordered me. Hey, I'm gonna tell you, as far as greatest rappers alive, I believe Andre 3000 is it. But this is one for the people that believe that there's other people that's greatest rappers. But This is the Notorious B.I.G. pop. And this is the one I've been wanting, this one, because I have another one there of him in a black tuxedo, but I couldn't find the one with him in the crown. So my wife, it's in a hard protector, excellent condition. So thank you, baby. So yeah, that's what's up. Hey, this is gonna be a good day. Tonight I'm gonna be at the museum, the Tampa Bay Museum of Photographic Arts. For those that don't know, I'm a photographer, and I have my wife and myself are photographers. So we're featured at the Tampa Museum of Photographic Arts for our work with the protests after the unfortunate George Floyd murder. And even though I have this vlog, and it's probably, I think this is gonna be my fifth episode, one of the biggest things that I wanna say in regards to this is Breonna Taylor's murderers are still free. I don't know why. It's America and everything has a process to it, I understand. But again, Breonna Taylor's murderers are still free. I got a problem with that. And anybody who doesn't have a problem with that, that's your business. You know, if you don't like it on my vlog, find another vlog. There's 1,000 comic book vlogs out there. People don't like when we talk about political things, but the Godfather Stan Lee, he was always political in his writing. If you don't believe it, you know, do your history, do your research. And yeah, so we have work that's going to be featured in the museum, the Tampa Museum of Photographic Arts. It's going to be throughout the month, all the way into September 5th, I believe. Shout out to the other members of the group, especially Ashley Kane. Check out, you know, my wife, Zaloria. She's the only one in the world. Check out her work as well. So that's what we're doing tonight. Like I said, it's going to be a dope day. And again, this your man, Jay. Peace. Holla at your boy. All right, folks. So help me out now. Hit the like button if you really like it. And if you're really, really digging it, go ahead and hit the subscribe button so you can get new content every week. And then hit that bell. Hit the little notification bell. There you go. Hit that notification bell. So each week, you'll know when I'm dropping some new content. Now go out, get you something new. Let's evolve, because we do this for the people. Love you.